Meine Damen und Herren, wir beginnen mit den Offiziellen des heutigen Abends. Veranstalter Sauerland Event GmbH, Promoter dieses Kampfabends, Kalle und Nisse Sauerland. Technischer Leiter Christian Meyer, Geschäftsführer Freddy Ness und Chris Meyer. EBU-Delegierte am heutigen Abend aus Belgien, Bob Logist, Ron Parrott, Supervisor British Boxing Board of Control, IBF Supervisor Lindsay Tucker. Wir kommen nun zu den Punktrichter des heutigen Abends. Aus Frankreich, Christophe Humbert. Aus Italien, Massimiliano Bianco. Und aus der Schweiz, Beat Hausermann. Ringrichter dieses Europameisterschaftskampfes wird sein Manuel Oliver Palomo aus Spanien. Ringärzte am heutigen Abend Dr. Sandra Filmer und Professor Dr. Walter Wagner aus Bayreuth. Meine Damen und Herren, Ladies and Gentlemen, it's time to fight! Wir kommen zum Kämpfer in der blauen Ecke. Er ist 35 Jahre alt, 1,94 Meter groß, 113 Kilogramm schwer. Seine Kampfbilanz: 23 Kämpfe, 22 Siege, 12 davon durch Knockout. In seiner Ecke Erfolgstrainer Uli Wegner, Georg Bramowski, Cutman Giulio Spagnoli und Physiotherapeut Ralf Lewandowski. Meine Damen und Herren, aus Bulgarien, Sofia Kubrat, die Cobra! Sein Gegner in der roten Ecke ist 32 Jahre alt, 1,87 Meter groß, 109,7 Kilogramm schwer. Seine Kampfbilanz: 30 Kämpfe, 25 Siege, 17 davon durch Knockout. In seiner Ecke sein Trainer CJ Hussein, Gary Innes, Michael Collins und Michael Lopez. Meine Damen und Herren, Ladies and Gentlemen, directly from London, England, Jerry Delbo-Cisara! Die Kämpfer submit to the fighters to the middle.
You ready? Okay, thank you. Good
luck. You're going down, man. You're going down.
You're going down. Says the Brit, both Kubrat Pulev and Derek Chisora, promoted by the Sauerland brothers, who said if the pre-fight fireworks at the press conference and weigh-in are any indication, we could have high-octane action here in this fascinating and important heavyweight meeting. The European title at stake, both former champions, and it is also doubling up as an eliminator for Anthony Joshua's new IBF crown, so plenty at stake, and plenty of pride too between these experienced men.
Yeah, I think there is there's still respect between them both. They know they're tough fighters, and this is a tough one for either man, but it's important for Chisora to get in the fight early, to get his rhythm going. That's where he's good, when he gets a nice rhythm, lets the big punches go.
Yep, he wants a crowd. Pulev, who has the height and reach advantages, it was the better amateur five world championships. A huge amount of experience. There is that jab that has proved a pretty potent weapon all the way through his boxing career. But Chisora has plenty of power. He's a good inside fighter. And as he said, if he could get into a rhythm and he keeps interested round after round, that's a key.
That's very important, because he can't just slip off the boil midway through a fight, Chisora, not fancy it. But there's a great opportunity here with Pulev, who has weaknesses with his defense. He showed that against Vladimir Klitschko. He's wide open at times. He holds that left hand. It's kind of not really protecting him. It's just stuck out there a little bit. That's where he's opened the rights. So there is opportunities for Chisora.
Pulev was bounced up and down off the canvas by Vladimir Klitschko in November 2014 in Hamburg. Lost in five rounds, sole defeat of his career. Klitschko's really good that night.
Yeah, he was. It was a different kind of Klitschko. Really wanted to prove a point in that fight, and he did.
Good right hand from Pulev. Best shot so far in this, the opening round. And she's always had a fairly decent chin. David Haye did get rid of him in five. And it was a rather soporific second fight with Tyson Fury that saw him retire at the end of the 10th. But normally, he's pretty strong in that department, tough and rugged.
Pulev landing well with the right hand, and he's got the more eye-catching punches in this round.
Looks quick as well.
He does, he's sharp. Yeah, he's obviously, he knows this is a tough fight, and it's a great fight to propel him into world class and the world title shot. So he needs the win.
He's all trying to work the body, swings and lunges. Hasn't done enough here in the first, though. Pulev with the better start. Welcome back. And it was a sharp start from Kubrat Pulev.
Yeah, eye-catching punches with the right hand. She's already a little bit of them.
Only the 24th fight as a professional for Kubrat Pulev, who turned in 2009. Derek Chisora's past 30 in. He turned in 2007. And in many ways has fought at a higher level in tougher tests. It's been a fascinating journey, really. But how much is left at 32 for Derek Chisora? Can he come again? He's had five wins since that defeat to Tyson Fury, but at very low grade of opposition there. And he's in with a man who's pretty decent, Kubrat Pulev, and he could come again to fight for a world title.
Well, I think whoever gets the win here will get that opportunity somewhere along the line to fight for a world title. That's how important this fight is.
I know Chisora was in talks a while ago to fight Anthony Joshua, but he wanted to go a different route. He chose in many ways. Yeah, the European adventure, went out sparring in the States. He was ringside for Deontay Wilder's defense against Archer Spilker. He's very confident that he can rebuild. And he says it all starts here, that he'll take the fight to Kubrat Pulev and stop him. I suppose easier said than done with that sort of combination coming back at you.
That's right. He's just getting caught on the way in, Chisora. He's got to try and get into range quicker because he's allowing Pulev to tee off with that right hand.
Attempting to get the jab going, but he's being out-jabbed here, Chisora.
Yeah, large cheer from the crowd when that jab lands and pushes the head back.
Sometimes the upper body movement of Chisora has been a bit ponderous.
Yeah, and he needed a better start than this in the first couple of rounds, Chisora. This is where he can start to lose interest a little bit. If he's not getting his own shots on, he's starting to be tagged from long range.
Young frustration has set in the past for Chisora, and these jabs of Pulev are crisp and powerful. Trying to get his own back there, Chisora.
You can see why Pulev was so successful as an amateur with a really good jab. That's a point scorer and a hurtful punch.
He went everywhere as an amateur for a decade. So many multi-nation tournaments, Europeans, Worlds, even the Olympics in Beijing. Didn't always get the highest prize, had to settle for bronzes and silvers a lot of the time, but he was right in there. And that quality is there to see.
Yeah, I think there's five successive world championships, an Olympics. There's a lot of good pedigree work in the amateurs.
Good defense there as well. Tidy start this for Pulev.
Good number.
Well, Derek Chisora told us beforehand, I'll be all over him from the first bell. Hasn't quite worked, though. Those are raiding tactics. Just hasn't landed enough clean punches, but it is early days.
It is. That's been a problem with Chisora throughout his career. He can't get in range quick enough. He's a little ponderous as he comes forward, and that's where he can be picked off.
Both former European heavyweight champions. Chisora won it against Edmund Gerber in Hackney in five rounds in September 2013. Pulev won it against Alexander Dimitrenko, defended against Alexander Ustinov. Also has a win over Tony Thompson, which is good on the record too. Pulev.
Chisora coming in, this time trying to use a lot more head movement to avoid the jabs. And so far, he's doing that.
Bobbing and weaving type of style to get in close.
Yeah, a little bit of the old smoke and Joe Frazier there.
It was a really gallant display, wasn't it, against Vitali Klitschko. They had all the fireworks in the build-up, as usual, with Chisora, but he really did bite down on the gum shield and give Klitschko a workout.
Yeah, he did. He made his name a little bit with that performance, however, a losing performance. But he's avoiding the jab much more here, but needs to get his own punches off Chisora like that.
Yes, better there. Head and body from Chisora. He's whacking in hooks. Is giving weight away to Pulev, but he's in good fighting shape. Chisora at around 17-3, that's his lightest for a few years. And this could get draining, couldn't it?
It could. He's walking under that uppercut, which is a good punch. He's worked out exactly what he's doing with the head movement and then just trying to bring the punches up.
Yeah, beautiful shot that. From Pulev, sensible. As the shorter guy comes in, the uppercut. A terrific shot. And the crowd rallying behind their man. He really is well thought of. Chisora better in this round, though. Trying to get the combinations rattling home.
Yeah, he needs to carry on like that, Adam. Another good uppercut from Pulev. He's got to make use of this last 40 odd seconds. With some good work, he might get this round.
Kalle and Nisse Salen watching on, representing both of these guys. They've been with Pulev a long time, Chisora more recently. They're putting on a good match, combination back from Pulev, partially blocked from Chisora. A tighter session, Glenn.
Yeah, I think, you know, Chisora might have just done enough with some of that good rough work inside where, you know, their punches, they're landing, their point scoring.
They're trying the body markedly less from Pulev. A couple of eye-catching uppercuts, but work rate from Chisora better, and a looping right hand at the end of a decent round. Gary Innocent, CJ Hussain.
You slip.
With Derek Chisora's corner.
You need to have your slip, throw that right hand over the top. Yeah. Get going, Bubba. Go get him.
Intelligent guy, Derek Chisora. At times when you talk to him out of the ring, you can't sort of work out why he does the antics he does. The Valentine kiss, I remember, on Carl Baker all those years ago. Things like that, the mess with the David Haye build-up. But, you know, you talk to him at shows and he's bright, he's articulate.
Yeah, amiable.
Maybe it's a motivational tool.
Yeah, I think he's trying to get himself in that frame of mind. He's trying to be rough and aggressive, and when it comes fight time, he certainly does that.
Born in Zimbabwe, but grew up in Finchley. And, so run around Hampstead Heath a fair amount to build up for fights. Of course, Spencer Oliver and Anthony Joshua from those parts as well. Now Chisora would at some point love a shot at AJ. It could be a long way off. He's got to meet Kubrat Pulev first. And that jab is back in working order.
Yeah, he's took stock got the jab working again. He's catching Chisora at long range, not allowing Chisora to roll his way in.
Experienced Spanish referee, Manuel Oliver Palomo, taking care of proceedings. And there's that lever, the long jab, right hand from Chisora over the top. Got power, 17 knockouts in those 25 wins. Pulev, 12 knockouts in his 22 wins. He normally, when he gets them, does it late. Dimitrenko in 11, Usinov in 11, Sprott in 9. He wears you down, he's that type of a fighter.
Yeah, he's landing well with the long punches here. And again, just got him on the end of that combination.
So what, Lennox Lewis would have been proud of that, wouldn't he? The left and right. Good combination from Pulev. Chisora backed up on the ropes. He doesn't want to be there. And the crowd again rising to Kubrat Pulev, who many believe can still become a world champion even at 35. That he's fresh enough. And this is good stuff.
Yeah, much more dominant, isn't it, from Pulev? He's got Chisora on the ropes and can't get off there, and punishing him with jabs and right hands.
Fights his way out of the corner of the hole, Derek Chisora. As often he's done in patches through the career. But is he as effective now at this stage of his career?
A good round from Pulev, just to put himself in charge again in this fight.
Yep, definitely. Pulev's round.
Klug weiterboxen, einfach, dann ist es gut.
Das war gut, Pulev,
sehr gut. Aber du
trained by Uli Vigna. Looked after the sound of boxes for many years. Tons of experience. Very good at adapting the style from amateur to pro, isn't he, Glenn?
Yeah, I think that's very important. He's done it well for many, many years. Constant fixture in that corner with some very good fighters.
Fifth round, blue trunks of the Union Jack for Derek Chisora and the red of Kubrat Pulev. Remember, the vacant European heavyweight title on the line and an eliminator for the IBF title. You see how many thrown and landed. The stats all in favour of Pulev. What would you do now? CJ Hussain, Gary Innes in the corner. CJ Hussain's been with Derek a long time. Tactics advice, Glenn, what would you give them?
For me, I'd want to try and get him as close as he can to Pulev and start letting more punches go. Combinations inside. Pulev's good at long range, but you need to get in that middle and that short range. That's where, you know, he can work. I mean, he can also wear him down a little bit with them hard punches around the body and the head in the clinches.
There's that big right hand again. Can't get out of the way of all of these, Derek Chisora and the uppercut. It's all a bit too hot, a bit too much for Chisora.
Find a good rhythm, isn't he, Pulev? Nice and sharp, that 1-2's working well.
Yeah, some say he's clumsy on his feet, Pulev, but he's boxing to a plan here. Behind that jab, using his advantages. Just a gulp of air there from Derek Chisora.
Yeah, and a show of respect as well, apologising for the punch on the back of the head.
Trying to jab the body again, Chisora. Just not getting meat into them, not really committing.
Yeah, it looks like Pulev's starting to tame him a bit, isn't he? He's starting to, you know, chip down that anger of Chisora, which he needs to, you know, get the momentum. And he's just in control at this point, Pulev. Good defensive work.
After that style of the Eastern Europeans, the clinch goes so brilliant in it as they reign for a decade. Sometimes criticised for not being exciting, but so efficient and professional at the way they executed game plans and took control of the ring.
Yeah, well, he's got that jab working wonderfully well, Pulev. She's already looking a little bit tired.
I don't want this. Look.
He's complaining. He walks into a right hand there. Chisora, and another one.
Yes, he just looks as if he's starting to break down the defenses of Derek Chisora. Will the wheel start to go?
It's all Pulev. Chopping away, but with good skill.
Yeah, good skill, reflexes are good, sharpness is there, and he's punching with authority. Got a bit of venom in those shots, really winding that right uppercut up for the jab. That's just softened Chisora up, isn't it?
You've always said it's the best weapon for a heavyweight. Muhammad Ali, Larry Holmes, Lennox Lewis. Gotta have a great jab.
Yeah, Tyson Fury, Tyson Fury and AJ both got good jabs, and that's a lot to do with their success.
Tyson Fury at ringside. Of course, he is in training for the rematch with Vladimir Klitschko in July. Anthony Joshua defends his version of the world title against Dominic Brazil on June the 25th. Meanwhile, there's a Russian trip for Deontay Wilder in with Alexander Povetkin. And also on Sky, we'll be showing the fascinating final eliminator of the IBF title between Joseph Parker, the unbeaten man from New Zealand, 18-0, and Carlos Takam, who David Hay always says is such a good fighter. It really is a buzzing division. Hay back on May 21st as well.
Yep, terrific things happening in the heavyweight division, but here, this one, Pulev's annoyed. It looked as if Chisora maybe was trying to stick a part of his glove in his eye. That's really got him going. He's angry and he's taking it out on Chisora.
Chisora trying to find pressure to the body, but noticeably tired. He's just mentally showing signs here, Glenn, at the end of that jab, that it is all getting rather tough.
Yep. And you know, when he's trying a few dodgy strokes inside, that's a sign that, you know, the wheels are coming off a little bit on there. He's starting to unravel Derek Chisora.
Can be so dangerous, Chisora, if he's in the mood. And Pulev hasn't allowed him to be. He's never allowed to get the rhythm, but that's a better right hand from Chisora. Best shot of the fight so far. Did wake up Pulev, rattled him a little bit. Will that give him confidence?
Yeah, that certainly shook him. That was a good right hand. Needs to throw a few more then with a bit of venom, Chisora.
How will Pulev respond to that? The answer is back on the jab. It's all a bit wild and woolly from Chisora. Trying the left hook out. He's desperate for this wing, Glenn. He needs it so much. They both do.
Yeah, he's got to go for it a little bit, Chisora. Now he's got to gamble. Let some shots go. He knows he can stun Pulev. Another left hook landing.
He's had some good knockout wins. Danny Williams in a couple of rounds. Sam Sexton, he stopped. Malik Scott was a good one. Possibly his best ever win in the summer of 2013. There's a cut as well on the left eye of Pulev. So some success here for Derek Chisora.
Yeah, a little bit. He needs more than just one good connection, though. Well, he needs to be busy. He's going to try and get some combinations out, not just wait for one punch.
Right hand back from Pulev. Again on the ropes here. And a second. Chisora trying to fight fire with fire. Here's a bit of that action that the Salomon brothers were predicting. Engaging round, wasn't it?
Good round, exciting round, but it was a Pulev round. They're just getting a little bit rough. Just rubbing his glove up around the throat. Good right hand, though. That stunned Pulev. on the back foot there. He recovered well, though.
He's pretty mobile, isn't he, Pulev, for a big guy?
Yeah, he can when he needs to move. He likes to set himself and get his punches staying in the same place. But when he needs to skim out of the way, he can.
No real damage. On the left eye. Louis Vega with the instructions. For the second half of this European heavyweight title fight, Kubrat Pulev, the 35-year-old from Sofia, based largely in Germany. And Derek Chisora, a bit of a road warrior through the years. Fought all over the place. In England, of course. But he's had trips to Munich where he fought Vitali Klitschko. Nearly beat Robert Hellenius, maybe should have done, in Finland. And he's done a lot of work in the States as well. But you've got him in a bit of bother here.
Yeah, it's been pretty good from Pulev all the way through. One round, I thought, was pretty close. I just edged it to Chisora.
The ref cam there, as Chisora lands a right to the body. Got to try and slow him down, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's continually working away to the body when he's inside, hoping that'll hurt him a little bit, rough him up. But as soon as he gets back on the jab, he gets in control, Pulev.
He whipped himself into good neck, Derek Chisora. Yeah, but we saw him in December on the Joshua White card against Yakov Gospich, and he was just going through the motions, winning in three. Stopped Andras Kosmor in two in Offenburg. But he's having problems here, really, with the heavy hands and that accurate jab of Kubrat Pulev. It's a level up from what he's been used to over the last year or so, or two levels.
It is, and Pulev's fighting at a good pace. It was a lovely right hand he landed that got through and just stunned Chisora, put him on the back foot a little bit. It's getting hard, you feel, for Derek.
It was that strange performance against Tyson Fury second time round. First time was close, to the second time, though, he just didn't really seem to want it, to be interested. You know, I remember Frank Warren getting involved, and they just got fed up with him, and it looked like his career had nowhere to go, but he's breathed a bit of life into it. A few wins, teamed up with the Sauerlands, now this.
Yeah, well, you know, he certainly tries hard, doesn't he? He wants to get a break, and, you know, you've got to say hats off for doing that, trying to reinvent himself. He's got the shot he wants for the European title, and an eliminator for the world title. He's got to make the most of it. Chances might be running out.
Definitely, this is a big opportunity. And the rounds are ticking by. But Pulev knows he can ill afford another defeat after the disaster against Vladimir Klitschko. And that right hand is working well tonight. Not all landing cleanly, but more often behind the excellent jab. And Chisora with a one, just on the bell there. The Pulev fans, all smiles.
Yeah, they've got a lot to smile about. He's doing very well here. Kubrat Pulev in control, working well behind the jab. The right hands work well. They're working to the body inside, nothing wrong with that from Chisora. But Pulev happy enough to take it.
It's been a bit of a tactic, hasn't it, Chisora? The jab to the body and then the hooks, obviously, to slow the bigger guy down. But he just hasn't really put any sort of dent in Pulev.
No, that was the one good right hand. Pulev's taking the shot well from Chisora.
We're watching the roller coaster career of Derek Chisora as he walks into another right hand from the former amateur standout and good professional Kubrat Pulev, who's only lost one of 23, and he might be closing in on a world title shot. Chisora now getting angry with the referee. Doesn't want to be doing that.
No, that's not going to do him any favors at all.
boos from the crowd. They will have seen the footage at the weigh-in. He was hit by some sort of plastic bottle and went on a bit of a rampage. Chisora chasing Pulev's team around the hotel and into the back kitchens. You never know what you're going to get, do you?
No.
I don't think it's malicious, though, with Chisora sometimes. I think it's just...
it's just a loose cannon at times.
Yep.
You know, his head, when he loses it, he just goes with it.
As I say, he could be a joy to be around at times as well, Chisora, when you're talking boxing. But he's not having a joy or a pleasurable night in there.
No, you can tell he's getting frustrated, Adam. He's not getting the success that he wants. He's not landing the punches that he needs, and he's taken quite a lot.
Let's give real respect here to what Kubrat Pulev is doing. You know, he took a year off, didn't he, after the Klitschko defeat. He's only had a couple of comeback wins. This is really good.
Yeah, another shopping right hand as Chisora went down to avoid it, got caught.
Beat George Arias in October. He's been out since December, where he had a one-round victory over Maurice Harris. Used to be a Lennox Lewis sparring partner. Big right hand from Pulev. Chisora shakes his head, bit of defiance, but it's all becoming heavy weather for the Londoner.
Yeah, he's still aware, waiting to get that right hand on, but he doesn't need to be taken. Big right hands like that in succession.
The body shot as well from Pulev. Chisora just trying to hang in. Find something to give him confidence, but he's looking at the referee and not at Pulev. That's inexperience.
Yeah, I think it's frustration with the referee. Nothing's going his way. Where he looks comfortable, Pulev.
Swings in a good left hook to the body, Chisora. It's short cameos, though. It's the odd flashes of what we know he can do. But it just hasn't altogether worked, really, in any round. You've given him one, haven't you? I've found it difficult to even do that.
Yeah, it's the round where Pulev just stepped off the gas a bit. He didn't step off the gas in the eighth, though. Good round for Pulev.
Slow walk back to the corner for Derek Chisora. It's getting very tough now.
Pulev elected to stand between rounds now. He's comfortable. He's enjoying it.
Up. Wenn du jetzt nicht hörst, hier rüber und die Linke holst, das ist immer noch gefährlich.
It's often very technical, isn't it, from Uli Wegner, but it's been really effective all night, the plan.
Yeah, key for Pulev's that jab, that's working wonderfully well. Then he's bringing the right hand and the uppercut in, all textbook punches.
Three judges at ringside. Massimiliano Bianco from Italy, Beat Hausermann from Switzerland, Christophe Ombert from France, and I'm sure they're all seeing it pretty much the same way, almost a landslide here.
Yeah. Can he find one punch to Zora to turn the tide? He needs to find something.
I've had a few strange judges' interpretations in recent weeks. Then an Irene Leeds, there was one or two odd scorecards in that as Chisora fights a left hand. That's better. Also in Washington last weekend, some eyebrows were raised, but Chisora really trying to bulldoze his way through the defences of Pulev. And now it's Pulev who has to complain.
Yeah, this is better from Chisora. He needs to pull his way through. Just keep throwing punches. Use his strength.
Tyson Fury just shouting out some support to Chisora. Pulev back with the right hand. He's just got to sort of throw everything at it now. His career's on the line here a bit, Derek Chisora, certainly at this sort of level.
Yeah, he's just got to get some momentum and just keep that going. Can't allow Pulev some room to start getting that jab working again. Then the right hand, that's good from Pulev.
backing off, still finds the cleaner punches. It's rough and tough from Del Boy, who hangs in there. The referee's going to have a word here. Just sorting them out. Pulev back behind the jab. But he must be getting tighter as well now, Glenn.
Yeah, well, he's holding an awful lot. I think I heard Tyson Fury shouting at the ref to tell him to stop holding.
There's the right hand again from Jezora and the smile from Pulev. Could there be a late turnaround here? There's still plenty of time for Jezora.
But the referee is allowing Pulev to hold a bit too much.
This is with the uppercut. Jezora driving himself forward.
Spirited effort, isn't it?
And he holds again, Pulev, tying him up.
Been a better round for Jezora.
It has been. And he's needed it. Is that going to give him some impetus? Right hand again. This is much, much better from Derek Jezora. Didn't look like it was possible at one stage, but he's found it. He's found a little bit of rhythm here.
Yeah, I wonder if Pulev is weakening a bit physically because he is trying to hold. He's not working as much.
Body shot from Pulev. Right hand. Jezora answered as well. Another good round. Chisora's.
Definitely. Yep, that was a valiant effort, wasn't it, from Chisora, who just went for it, just threw as many punches as he could. He's sitting down after this round, isn't he, Pulev?
Machst das so gut, aber die Linke muss oben bleiben. Er hat immer so ein Ding noch drin, ja? Verstehst du mich?
Yeah, it just seemed as if he was starting to tire, feel the pace a little bit in that round, Pulev. That allowed Chisora to really work hard and pull out around and show he's still got something left.
Bouncing on his feet up early, Pulev, who was holding a bit in that last round. But it's an engaging fight, isn't it? It's a good one.
Yeah, it's a good one, yes. Plenty of actions, good skills as well.
No massive drama. Chisora landed a good shot in the sixth round and had a good night. Glad you gave him one of the earlier ones, but apart from that, it's pretty much been Kubrat Pulev behind the jab with the uppercuts, the right hands, the space, the timing. That's just... So far proved the winner here. He's got 9 minutes left, Derek Chisora, to try and salvage this European heavyweight title shot, regain that belt that he once held. Shot Derek, they're saying in the corner. They're still believing. He missed that by a country mile. Is he as good as he was when he fought Vitali Klitschko, Derek Chisora?
No, I'm not sure he quite is. I think that was his big night. He put everything he possibly could into that. And I don't think he's quite the same.
It's the combinations that aren't really flowing for Chisora. The old sporadic shot, but there's the right again from Pulev. Back behind that jab. That's where Chisora can ill afford to be at this stage.
He needn't be there. He needs to get out, work away, push him on the back foot. He's got to try and take it away from Pulev. You know, he looked like he was starting to tire in the last round a bit. It needs a big, big effort from Del Boy.
Body shots again. Trying to rattle them home, but redded now, Pulev. But he's strong and tough. Condition, but they normally are, I think, Vector.
Yeah, he's done his work in the gym. Pulev holding on a little bit. Just the referee, I'd like to see him shout break and let Pulev step off. He's not doing that.
David Price, who is making his ring return at the Everton show, Goodison Park. Tony Bellew card on Sunday, May the 29th. He sparred with both of them. He fancied Pulev to win this on points. probably going to be right, unless Chisora can somehow step it up again. Had a good night, needed a very good 10th. Hasn't had it.
Now, Lan with a few body punches, trying to push forward there, but it looks as if Chisora is feeling the effects of that big round in the last. It's been quite a physical fight as well. There's been lots of pulling and work inside like that, which takes an awful lot out of you.
There's been plenty of commitment from both of them.
Oh, very much so. You can see how much this fight means to both of them. Important fight.
Pulev offers the glove. Chisora doesn't want to know. He wants to sit down.
Well, there's been a bit too much of this with Chisora content to stay on it, on the ropes in the corner, and that's give Pulev some good opportunities in the round to really be in control. Not enough in that round for Derek Chisora. Long left.
Glimpses, flashes from Chisora. Plenty of heart, grit. He's stubborn as always. But the quality has been with this man, Kubrat Pulev. Into the 11th round. And he's had success here before. Pulev with a couple of stoppage wins over Dimitrenko and Ustinov. A good level that, since to get you late on, you've got him six up.
Yep. Not long left for Chisora to try and salvage this. Can't for me on points.
Just double the punches thrown. Quality-wise, double landed. Tells the story. Bit of holding, yes, from Pulev. Little bit of a sign, possibly, around the ninth of Chisora. Trying to turn this around, and he's still in there. He's still trying to throw the leather. But it's more wayward. I mean, they're both tired now.
Yeah, but it's been some good work from Pulev, and, you know, he's going to be tough. He's going to be a tough opponent for anybody out there, isn't he?
I was just about to ask you, you know, how do you think he fares with the likes of a young Joseph Parker or a Carlos Takam, or, of course, of Anthony Joshua or Tyson Fury?
Well, I think a really good opponent for the likes of Anthony Joshua, because he's solid. You know, he's had good amateur success for a long, long time. You know, and he's you know, there's only Vladimir Klitschko has really upset him and got him out of there. So, this, you know, this is somebody where you'd get rounds out of Joshua.
Yep, maybe a good opponent for Joshua later in the year. Kubrat Pulev, he's ranked 3 by the WBC, 15 by the WBA, 6 by the IBF. And winning this eliminator puts him right in the mix. Jabs and right hands and the uppercut. And left from Chisora here, and a body shot as well. Swing and a miss, and that right eye is puffing up too for Derek Chisora.
Yeah, he's under fire here. Chisora keeps trying to fight back off the ropes with that big overhand right, but the defense of Pulev is kept pretty tight the second part of the fight.
Jumps in with the left hook, but looks down at his corner. Chisora, as if to say, just hasn't been my night. Nothing's really worked, and the jab there was almost non-existent, and he's back in the corner. And Pulev could just tee off on him again. This is exactly what he does. If he's trying to play possum, isn't all this too late?
Yep, solid round again for Pulev. It looks like he's resigned himself to a loss here, Chisora.
Yeah, he just falls on the top rope there, Derek Chisora. Almost a forlorn figure. And Kubrat Pulev, the blood to the head, as well as that cut to the eye. but at this stage, nothing to worry about. Got to knock him out, Derek Chisora, if he's going to take the European title back. And on the evidence so far, I would say very unlikely.
Yeah, he's tried hard, Chisora, but he's just been caught on the end of that jab in the right hand far too much. And hasn't been able to really get himself established in this fight. But another solid performance from Chisora.
Nothing wrong.
Never enough.
Nothing wrong with his spirit and his fight, Derek Chisora. He's tried very hard. He's just been outclassed by the excellent amateur, a very solid professional, Kubrat Pulev, who was a pretty big favourite beforehand. And you could see why. Inside the last 3 minutes, a massive win for Tyson Fury, ending the reign of Vladimir Klitschko late last year in Germany, was a big upset. But it'll be a massive upset now if Derek Chisora was to take out Kubrat Pulev and become European champion. The jab back in his face, and look at that. How despondent does he feel now, Chisora? Right hand as well from Pulev, looking down at ringside, Chisora. It's almost as if he wants to hear the final bell now, despite the fact he's a brave fighting man and he's always given us value for money.
Yeah, he's resigned himself to the loss. I think that was pretty apparent halfway through this, that he just couldn't get himself in there. He was being outboxed behind that jab and that sharp right hand, and it's been a good performance from Kubrat Pulev. Certainly plenty fighting him at 35 years of age.
Pulev looking for another world title shot, I would say later this year or maybe early 2017, as he springs another jab in on Derek Chisora, which he's done effectively from the first bell. What of the Finchley man at 32? We said he's not old for a heavyweight, but it's been a hard career, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. I mean, there's still plenty fight in him. I wouldn't say it's time to hang him up or anything like that. It's a incredible performance.
Are we talking domestic level, maybe going in with the likes of a David Price or something, a British title, or what would you do with Chisora?
Well, you know, I mean, Chisora is one of those where, you know, he's gonna be an opponent, he's gonna be somebody that gives top class fighters a hard test and a run for the money and gets a few rounds in.
That right eye giving him problems, Chisora, back defending himself. And sure, the Salas will be very proud of his effort, and I'm sure he will get opportunities if he wants them again, Chisora. But it's Pulev's night here in front of his crowd. And the efforts of Derek Chisora, who hasn't stopped trying, just haven't been good enough.
No, he's been on the wrong end of that very good jab and the right hand. That's been the story.
Sacks back on the ropes there, Glenn. Sorry to interrupt, last 15 seconds. No grandstand finish for Chisora. Pulev, technically effective from start to finish. Threw more, landed more, classier, and wins the European title, no doubt. He laughs at Derek Chisora raising his hand. Well, he should have respect, and they should both have respect for each other for going 12 rounds in what was an interesting fight to watch, especially in that ninth. You thought maybe Chisora could come on strong, but it just wasn't his night. Hats off to Kubrat Pulev. He looks a player again in this heavyweight division.
He certainly does. That's my card, 118-110. Pretty solid win there for Pulev. Doesn't tell the whole story. Chisora was game, kept trying, but was always behind and always on the end of that good jab.
Three judges from Italy, Switzerland and France, as Pulev takes the applause. And there's no celebrations in that corner. It's all rather sad, and you can't tell Derek Chisora that he didn't try ever so hard. He wanted it, he trained frenetically for it, that eye really gave him trouble in the last three or four rounds. But Pulev, I think that was an excellent performance.
Yep, certainly was, and he's going to get a big opportunity soon. Who will that be? I'm not sure. But he shows that, you know, he can handle it at this sort of level, and that's always been the doubt about Derek Chisora. He's just not quite the top world class.
The Bulgarians mixed with the Germans, who he's befriended, the popular figure, who at 35 will hope to get a second world title opportunity. There is the respect from Derek Chisora, who must be crestfallen, and Tyson Fury, who made the journey to cheer on his old foe, looking a little despondent. Wasn't messy though, hard fought encounter. That's what we like to see.
Yeah, no, good action for a heavyweight bout. They worked very hard. We had good quality as well with the jabs and the right hands, nice and sharp from Pulev. It was a good fight.
Kalle Sauerland there with Uli Wegner. Nisse in the ring. He's probably going to console Derek Chisora. Difficult when you promote both of them. And surely the judges will have this wide. Game, Chisora, as always. But he knows he's lost this.
Verkündung. The results. Mr. Bianco scored 116-112 for Pulev. 116-112 for Pulev. Bernd Hausermann scored 115-113. 115-113 for Chisora.
Chisora 115-113 from the Swiss judge.
And Monsieur Humbert scored 118-110, 118-110, und damit neuer EBU-Europameister im Schwergewicht, Kubrat, die Cobra Pulev.
Fairly wide on two, and a very, very bizarre card from the Swiss judge. Beat Hausermann, how on earth, 150 to 113 for Chisora, who was brave. He knew he'd lost, and he knew he lost wide. Well done, Kubrat Pulev, new European champion, and possible one. Trying to get his own back there, Chisora.
You can see why Pulev was so successful as an amateur with a really good jab. That's a point scorer and a hurtful punch.
He went everywhere as an amateur for a decade. So many multi-nation tournaments, Europeans, Worlds, even the Olympics in Beijing. Didn't always get the highest prize, had to settle for bronzes and silvers a lot of the time, but he was right in there. And that quality is there to see.
Yeah, I think there's five successive world championships, an Olympics. There's a lot of good pedigree work in the amateurs.
Good defense there as well. Tidy start this for Pulev. Well, Derek Chisora told us beforehand, I'll be all over him from the first bell. Hasn't quite worked though, those are raiding tactics, just hasn't landed enough clean punches, but it is early days.
It is. That's been a problem with Chisora throughout his career. He can't get in range quick enough. He's a little ponderous as he comes forward, and that's where he can be picked off.
Both former European heavyweight champions. Chisora won it against Edmund Gerber in Hackney in five rounds in September 2013. Pulev. Won it against Alexander Dimitrenko, defended against Alexander Ustinov. Also has a win over Tony Thompson, which is good on the record too. Pulev.
Zora coming in, this time trying to use a lot more head movement to avoid the jabs. And so far, he's doing that.
Bobbing and weaving type of style to getting close.
Yeah, a little bit of the old smoke and Joe Frazier there.
It was a really gallant display, wasn't it, against Vitali Klitschko. They had all the fireworks in the build-up, as usual, with Chisora, but he really did bite down on the gum shield and give Klitschko a workout.
Yeah, he did. He made his name a little bit with that performance, however, a losing performance. But he's avoiding the jab much more here, but needs to get his own punches off Chisora like that.
Yes, better there. Head and body from Chisora. Just whacking in hooks. Is giving weight away to Pulev, but he's in good fighting shape. Chisora at around 17-3, that's his lightest for a few years. And this could get draining, couldn't it?
It could. He's walking onto that uppercut, which is a good punch. He's worked out exactly what he's doing with the head movement and then just trying to bring the punches up.
Yeah, beautiful shot that. From Pulev, sensible. As the shorter guy comes in, the uppercut. A terrific shot. And the crowd rallying behind their man. He really is well thought of. Chisora better in this round, though. Trying to get the combinations rattling home.
Yeah, he needs to carry on like that, Adam. Another good uppercut from Pulev. He's got to make use of this last 40 odd seconds. With some good work, he might get this round.
Kalle Nissi Salen watching on, representing both of these guys. They've been with Pulev a long time, Chisora more recently. They're putting on a good match. Combination back from Pulev, partially blocked from Chisora. A tighter session, Glenn.
Yeah, I think, you know, Chisora might have just done enough with some of that good rough work inside, where, you know, their punches, they're landing, their point scoring.
They're trying the body markedly less from Pulev. A couple of eye-catching uppercuts, but work rate from Chisora better, and a looping right hand at the end of a decent round. Gary Innocent, CJ Hussain.
A new slip.
Derek Chisora's corner.
You need to have your slip and show that right hand over the top. Oh, yeah. Get going, Bubba. Go get him.
Intelligent guy, Derek Chisora, at times when you talk to him out of the ring, you can't sort of work out why he does the antics he does. The Valentine kiss, I remember, on Carl Baker all those years ago. Things like that, the mess with the David Hay build-up. But, you know, you talk to him at shows and he's bright, he's articulate.
Amiable.
Maybe it's a motivational tool.
Yeah, I think he's trying to get himself in that frame of mind. He's trying to be rough and aggressive, and when it comes fight time, he certainly does that.
Born in Zimbabwe, but grew up in Finchley. And, so run around Hampstead Heath a fair amount to build up for fights. Of course, Spencer Oliver and Anthony Joshua from those parts as well. Al Chisora would at some point love a shot at AJ. But it could be a long way off. He's got to meet Kubrat Pulev first. And that jab is back in working order.
Yeah, he's took stock. Got the jab working again. He's catching Chisora at long range, not allowing Chisora to roll his way in.
Experienced Spanish referee Manuel Oliver Palomo taking care of proceedings. And there's that lever, the long jab, right hand from Chisora over the top. Got power, 17 knockouts in those 25 wins. Pulev, 12 knockouts in his 22 wins. He normally, when he gets them, does it late. Dimitrenko in 11, Ustinov in 11, Sprott in 9. He wears you down, he's that type of a fighter.
Yeah, he's landing well with the long punches here. And again, just got him on the end of that combination.
So what, Lennox Lewis would have been proud of that, wouldn't he? The left and right. Good combination from Pulev. Chisora backed up on the ropes. He doesn't want to be there. And the crowd again rising to Kubrat Pulev, who many believe can still become a world champion even at 35, that he's fresh enough. And this is good stuff.
Yeah, much more dominant, isn't it, from Pulev? He's got Chisora on the ropes and can't get off there, and punishing him with jabs and right hands.
Fights his way out of the corner of the hole, Derek Chisora. As often he's done in patches through the career. But is he as effective now at this stage of his career?
A good round from Pulev just to put himself in charge again in this fight.
Yep, definitely. Pulev's round.
Klug weiterboxen, einfach, dann ist es gut.
Das war gut,
sehr gut. Aber du musst
looked after the sound and boxes for many years, tons of experience, and very good at adapting the style from amateur to pro, isn't he, Glenn?
Yeah, I think that's very important. He's done it well for many, many years. Constant fixture in that corner with some very good fighters.
Fifth round, the blue trunks and the Union Jack for Derek Chisora, and the red of Kubrat Pulev. Remember, the vacant European heavyweight title on the line and an eliminator for the IBF title. You see how many thrown and landed. The stats all in favour of Pulev. What would you do now? CJ Hussain, Gary Innes in the corner. CJ Hussain's been with Derek a long time. Tactics advice, Glenn, what would you give him?
For me, I'd want to try and get him as close as he can to Pulev and start letting more punches go. Combinations inside. Pulev's good at long range, but you need to get in that middle and that short range. That's where, you know, he can work him. And he can also wear him down a little bit with them hard punches around the body and the head in the clinches.
Big right hand again. Can't get out of the way of all of these, Derek Chisora, and the uppercut. It's all a bit too hot, a bit too much for Chisora.
Finding a good rhythm, isn't he, Pulev? Nice and sharp. That 1-2's working well.
Yeah, some say he's clumsy on his feet, Pulev, but he's boxing to a plan here. Behind that jab, using his advantages. Just a gulp of air there from Derek Chisora.
Yeah, and a show of respect as well, apologising for the punch on the back of the head.
He's trying to jab the body against Chisora. Just not getting meat into them, not really committing.
Yeah, it looks like Pulev's starting to tame him a bit, isn't he? He's starting to, you know, chip down that anger of Chisora, which he needs to, you know, get the momentum, and he's just in control at this point, Pulev. Good defensive work.
Often that style of the Eastern Europeans, the Klitschkos, so brilliant in it as they reigned for a decade. Sometimes criticised for not being exciting, but so efficient and professional at the way they executed game plans and took control of the ring.
Yeah, well, he's got that jab working wonderfully well, Pulev. Chisora looking a little bit tired. I don't
want this. Yeah, he's complaining. He walks into a right hand there, Chisora, and another one.
Yes, he just looks as if he's starting to break down the defences of Derek Chisora. Will the wheel start to go?
It's all Pulev. Chopping away, but with good skill.
Yeah, good skill, reflexes are good, sharpness is there, and he's punching with authority. got a bit of venom in those shots, really winding that right uppercut up for the jab. That's just softened Chisora up, isn't it?
You've always said it's the best weapon for a heavyweight. Muhammad Ali, Larry Holmes, Lennox Lewis. Gotta have a great jab.
Yeah, Tyson Fury, Tyson Fury and AJ both got good jabs, and that's a lot to do with their success.
Tyson Fury at ringside. Of course, he is in training for the rematch with Vladimir Klitschko in July. Anthony Joshua defends his version of the world title against Dominic Brazil on June the 25th. Meanwhile, there's a Russian trip for Deontay Wilder in with Alexander Povetkin. And also on Sky, we'll be showing the fascinating final eliminator of the IBF title between Joseph Parker, the unbeaten man from New Zealand, 18-0, and Carlos Takam, who David Haye always says is such a good fighter. It really is a buzzing division. Haye back on May 21st as well.
Yep, terrific things happening in the heavyweight division, but here, this one, Pulev's annoyed. It looked as if Chisora maybe was trying to stick a part of his glove in his eye. That's really got him going. He's angry and he's taking it out on Chisora.
Chisora trying to find pressure to the body, but noticeably tired. He's just mentally showing signs here, Glenn, at the end of that jab, that it is all getting rather tough.
Yeah, and when he's trying a few dodgy strokes inside, that's a sign that the wheels are coming off a little bit, aren't they? He's starting to unravel Derek Chisora.
Can be so dangerous, Chisora, if he's in the mood. And Pulev hasn't allowed him to be. He's never allowed to get the rhythm, but that's a better right hand from Chisora. Best shot of the fight so far. Did wake up Pulev, rattled him a little bit. Will that give him confidence?
Yeah, that certainly shook him. That was a good right hand. Needs to throw a few more of them with a bit of venom, Chisora.
How will Pulev respond to that? The answer is back on the jab. It's all a bit wild and woolly from Chisora. Trying the left hook out. He's desperate for this wing, Glenn. He needs it so much. They both do.
Yeah, he's got to go for it a little bit, Chisora. Now he's got to gamble, let some shots go. He knows he can stun Pulev. Another left hook landing.
He's had some good knockout wins. Danny Williams in a couple of rounds. Sam Sexton, he stopped. Malik Scott was a good one. Possibly his best ever win in the summer of 2013. There's a cut as well on the left eye of Pulev. So some success here for Derek Chisora.
Yeah, a little bit. He needs more than just one good connection, though. Well, he needs to be busy. He's going to try and get some combinations out, not just wait for one punch.
Right hand back from Pulev. Again on the ropes here, and a second. Chisora trying to fight fire with fire. Here's a bit of that action that the Sauerland brothers were predicting. Engaging round, wasn't it?
Good round, exciting round, but it was a Pulev round. They're just getting a little bit rough, just rubbing his glove up around the throat. Good right hand, though. That stunned Pulev on the back foot there. He recovered well, though.
He's pretty mobile, isn't he, Pulev, for a big guy?
Yeah, he can when he needs to move. He likes to set himself and get his punches staying in the same place. But when he needs to skim out of the way, he can.
No real damage on the left eye. Billy Vega with the instructions for the second half of this European heavyweight title fight. Kubrat Pulev, the 35-year-old from Sofia, based largely in Germany. And Derek Chisora, a bit of a road warrior through the years. fought all over the place in England, of course, but he's had trips to Munich where he fought Vitali Klitschko, nearly beat Robert Hellenius, maybe should have done, in Finland. And he's done a lot of work in the States as well, but you've got him in a bit of bother here.
Yeah, it's been pretty good from Pulev all the way through. One round, I thought, was pretty close. I just edged it to Chisora.
The ref cam there, as Chisora lands a right to the body. Got to try and slow him down, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's continually working away to the body when he's inside, hoping that that'll hurt him a little bit, rough him up. But as soon as he gets back on the jab, he gets in control, Pulev.
He whipped himself into good neck, Derek Chisora. Yeah, but we saw him in December on the Joshua White card against Yakov Gospic, and he was just going through the motions, winning in three. Stopped Andres Kosmor in two in Offenburg. But he's having problems here, really, with the heavy hands and that accurate jab of Kubrat Pulev. It's a level.
Meine Damen und Herren, wir beginnen mit den Offiziellen des heutigen Abends. Veranstalter Sauerland Event GmbH, Promoter dieses Kampfabends, Kalle und Nisse Sauerland. Technischer Leiter Christian Meyer, Geschäftsführer Freddy Ness und Chris Meyer. EBU Delegierte am heutigen Abend aus Belgien, Bob Logist. Ron Parrott, Supervisor British Boxing Board of Control. IBF Supervisor Lindsay Tucker. Wir kommen nun zu den Punktrichtern des heutigen Abends. Aus Frankreich, Christophe Humbert. Aus Italien, Massimiliano Bianco. Und aus der Schweiz, Beat Hausermann. Ringrichter dieses Europameisterschaftskampfes wird sein Manuel Oliver Palomo aus Spanien. Ringärzt am heutigen Abend Dr. Sandra Filmer und Professor Dr. Walter Wagner aus Bayreuth. Meine Damen und Herren, Ladies and Gentlemen, it's time to fight! Wir kommen zum Kämpfer in der blauen Ecke. Er ist 35 Jahre alt, 1,94 Meter groß, 113 Kilogramm schwer. Seine Kampfbilanz, 23 Kämpfe, 22 Siege, 12 davon durch Knockout. In seiner Ecke Erfolgstrainer Uli Wegner, Georg Bramowski, Cutman Giulio Spagnoli und Physiotherapeut Ralf Lewandowski. Meine Damen und Herren, aus Bulgarien, Sofia Kubrat, die Cobra Pule. Sein Gegner in der roten Ecke ist 32 Jahre alt, 1,87 Meter groß, 109,7 Kilogramm schwer. Seine Kampfbilanz, 30 Kämpfe, 25 Siege, 17 davon durch Knockout. In seiner Ecke sein Trainer CJ Hussein, Gary Innes, Michael Collins und Michael Lopez. Meine Damen und Herren, Ladies and Gentlemen, directly from London, England, Jerry the Kämpfer zur Mitte, the fighters to the middle.
You ready? Okay, thank you.
You're going down, man, you're going down.
You're going down, says the Brit. Both Kubrat Pulev and Derek Chisora, promoted by the Sauerland brothers, who said if the pre-fight fireworks at the press conference and weigh-in are any indication, we could have high-octane action here in this fascinating and important heavyweight meeting. The European title at stake, both former champions, and it is also doubling up as an eliminator for Anthony Joshua's new IBF crown. So plenty at stake, and plenty of pride too, between these experienced men.
Yeah, I think there's still respect between them both. They know the tough fighters, and this is a tough one for either man, but it's important for Chisora to get in the fight early, to get his rhythm going. That's where he's good, when he gets a nice rhythm, lets the big punches go.
Yep, he wants to crowd Pulev, who has the height and reach advantages. It was the better amateur 5 world championships. A huge amount of experience. There is that jab that has proved a pretty potent weapon all the way through his boxing career. But Chisora has plenty of power. He's a good inside fighter. And as he said, if he could get into a rhythm and he keeps interested round after round, that's a key for Chisora.
That's very important, because he can't just slip off the boil midway through a fight, Chisora, not fancy it. But there's a great opportunity here with Pulev, who has weaknesses with his defense. He showed that against Vladimir Klitschko, where he's wide open at times. He holds that left hand. It's kind of not really protecting him. It's just stuck out there a little bit. And that's where he's opened the rights. So there is opportunities for Chisora.
Pulev was bounced up and down off the canvas by Vladimir Klitschko in November 2014 in Hamburg. Lost in 5 rounds, sole defeat of his career. Klitschko was really good that night.
Yeah, he was. It was a different kind of Klitschko. Really wanted to prove a point in that fight, and he did.
Good right hand from Pulev. Best shot so far in this, the opening round. And Chisora's had a fairly decent chin. David Haye did get rid of him in 5. And it was a rather soporific second fight with Tyson Fury that saw him retire at the end of the 10th. But normally, he's pretty strong in that department, tough and rugged.
Pulev landing well with the right hand, and he's got the more eye-catching punches in this round.
Looks quick as well.
He does, he's sharp. Yeah, he knows this is a tough fight. And it's a great fight to propel him into world class and the world title shot. So he needs the win.
He's all trying to work the body, swings and lunges. Hasn't done enough here in the first, though. Pulev with the better start. Welcome back. And it is a sharp start from Kubrat Pulev.
Yeah, eye-catching punches with the right hand. Chisora a little bit open.
Only the 24th fight as a professional for Kubrat Pulev, who turned in 2009. Derek Chisora's past 30 in. He turned in 2007, and in many ways has fought at a higher level in tougher tests. It's been a fascinating journey, really. But how much is left at 32 for Derek Chisora? Can he come again? He's had 5 wins since that defeat to Tyson Fury, but at very low grade of opposition there. And he's in with a man who's pretty decent, Kubrat Pulev, and he could come again to fight for a world title.
Well, I think whoever gets the win here will get that opportunity somewhere along the line to fight for a world title. That's how important this fight is.
Chisora was in talks a while ago to fight Anthony Joshua, but he wanted to go a different route. He chose in many ways. Yeah, the European adventure, went out sparring in the States. He was ringside for Deontay Wilder's defense against Archer Spilker. He's very confident that he can rebuild. And he says it all starts here, that he'll take the fight to Kubrat Pulev and stop him. I suppose easier said than done with that sort of combination coming back at you.
That's right. He's just getting caught on the way in, Chisora. He's got to try and get into range quicker, because he's allowing Pulev to tee off with that right hand.
Attempting to get the jab going, but he's being out-jabbed here, Chisora.
Yeah, large cheer from the crowd when that jab lands and pushes the head back.
Sometimes the upper body movement of Chisora has been a bit ponderous.
Yeah, and he needed a better start than this in the first couple of rounds, Chisora. this is where he can start to lose interest a little bit. If he's not getting his own shots on, he's starting to be tagged from long range.
Yep, frustration has set in the past for Chisora, and these jabs of Pulev are crisp and powerful. Up from what he's been used to over the last year or so, yeah, or two levels.
It is, and Pulev's fighting at a good pace. It was a lovely right hand he landed that got through and just stunned Chisora, put him on the back foot a little bit. It's getting hard, you feel, for Derek.
It was that strange performance against Tyson Fury, second time round. First time was close, and the second time, though, he just didn't really seem to want it, to be interested. You know, I remember Frank Warren getting involved, and they just... they just got fed up with him, and it looked like his career had nowhere to go, but he's breathed a bit of life into it. A few wins, teamed up with the Sauerlands. Now this.
Yeah, well, you know, he certainly tries hard, doesn't he? He wants to get a break. And, you know, you've got to say hats off for doing that, trying to reinvent himself. He's got the shot he wants for the European title and an eliminator. For the world title, he's got to make the most of it. Chances might be running out.
Definitely, this is a big opportunity. And the rounds are ticking by. But Pulev knows he can ill afford another defeat after the disaster against Vladimir Klitschko. And that right hand is working well tonight. Not all landing cleanly, but more often. Behind the excellent jab. And Chisora with a one, just on the bell there. The Pulev fans, all smiles.
Yeah, they've got a lot to smile about. He's doing very well here. Kubrat Pulev in control, working well behind the jab. The right hands work well. Yeah, working to the body inside, nothing wrong with that from Chisora. But Pulev happy enough to take it.
It's been a bit of a tactic, hasn't it, Chisora? The jab to the body and then the hooks, obviously, to slow the bigger guy down. But he just hasn't really put any sort of dent in Pulev.
No, that was the one good right hand. Pulev's taking the shot well. From Chisora.
We're watching the roller coaster career of Derek Chisora as he walks into another right hand from the former amateur standout. And good professional Kubrat Pulev. He's only lost one of 23. And he might be closing in on a world title shot. Chisora now getting angry with the referee. Doesn't want to be doing that.
No, that's not going to do him any favours at all.
Boos from the crowd. They will have seen the footage at the weigh-in. He was hit by some sort of plastic bottle and went on a bit of a rampage. Chisora chasing Pulev's team around the hotel and into the back kitchens. You never know what you're going to get, do you?
No.
I don't think it's malicious, though, with Chisora sometimes. I think it's just...
it's just a loose cannon at times.
Yep.
You know, his head, when he loses it, he just goes with it.
Yeah, he can be a joy to be around at times as well, Chisora, when you're talking boxing. But he's not having a joy or a pleasurable night in there.
No, you can tell he's getting frustrated, Adam. He's not getting the success that he wants. He's not landing the punches that he needs, and he's taking quite a lot.
Let's give real respect here to what Kubrat Pulev is doing. You know, he took a year off, didn't he, after the Klitschko defeat. He's only had a couple of comeback wins. This is really good.
Yeah, another shopping right hand as Chisora went down to avoid it, got caught.
Beat George Arias in October. He's been out since December, where he had a one-round victory over Maurice Harris. Used to be a Lennox Lewis sparring partner. Big right hand from Pulev. Chisora shakes his head, bit of defiance, but it's all becoming heavy weather for the Londoner.
Yeah, he's still aware, waiting to get that right hand on, but he doesn't need to be taking big right hands like that in succession.
The body shot as well from Pulev. Chisora just trying to hang in. Find something to give him confidence, but he's looking at the referee and not at Pulev. That's inexperience.
Yeah, I think it's frustration with the referee. Nothing's going his way. Where he looks comfortable, Pulev.
Swings in a good left hook to the body, Chisora. It's short cameos, though. It's the odd flashes of what we know he can do. But it just hasn't altogether worked, really, in any round. You've given him one, haven't you? I've found it difficult to even do that.
Yeah, it's a round where Pulev just stepped off the gas a bit. He didn't step off the gas in the eighth, though. Good round for Pulev.
Slow walk back to the corner for Derek Chisora. It's getting very tough now.
Pulev electing to stand between rounds now. He's comfortable. He's enjoying it.
Up. Wenn du jetzt nicht hörst, hier rüber und die linke holst, das ist immer noch gefährlich.
It's often very technical, isn't it, from Uli Wegner, but it's been really effective all night, the plan.
Yeah, key for Pulev's that jab, that's working wonderfully well. Then he's bringing the right hand and the uppercut in, all textbook punches.
Three judges at ringside. Massimiliano Bianco from Italy, Beat Hausermann from Switzerland, Christophe Ombert from France, and I'm sure they're all seeing it pretty much the same way, almost a landslide here.
Yeah. Can he find one punch, Chisora, to turn the tide? He needs to find something.
I've had a few strange judges' interpretations in recent weeks. Then an Irene Leeds, there was one or two odd scorecards in that as Chisora finds a left hand. That's better. Also in Washington last weekend, some eyebrows were raised, but Chisora really trying to pull those his way through the defences of Pulev. And now it's Pulev who has to complain.
Yeah, this is better from Chisora. He needs to pull his way through. Just keep throwing punches. Use his strength.
Tyson Fury just shouting out some support to Chisora. Pulev back with a right hand. He's just got to sort of throw everything at it now. His career's on the line here a bit, Derek Chisora, certainly at this sort of level.
Yeah, he's just got to get some momentum and just keep that going. Can't allow Pulev some room to start getting that jab working again. Then the right hand, that's good from Pulev.
Backing off, still finds the cleaner punches. It's rough and tough from Del Boy, who hangs in there. The referee's going to have a word here. Just sorting them out. Pulev back behind the jab. But he must be getting tighter as well now, Glenn.
Yeah, well, he's holding an awful lot. I think I heard Tyson Fury shouting at the ref to tell him to stop holding.
There's the right hand again from Chisora and the smile from Pulev. Could there be a late turnaround here? There's still plenty of time for Chisora.
But the referee is allowing Pulev to hold a bit too much.
This is with the uppercut. Chisora driving himself forward.
Spirited effort, isn't it?
And he holds again, Pulev, tying him up.
Been a better round for Chisora.
It has been, and he's needed it. Is that going to give him some impetus? Right hand again. This is much, much better from Derek Chisora. Didn't look like it was possible at one stage, but he's found it. He's found a little bit of rhythm here.
Yeah, I wonder if Pulev is weakening a bit physically because he is trying to hold. He's not working as much.
Body shot from Pulev, right hand. Chisora answers as well. Another good round. Chisora's.
Definitely. Yep, that was a valiant effort, wasn't it, from Chisora, who just went for it, just threw as many punches as he could. He's sitting down after this round, isn't he, Pulev?
Du triffst das, das machst du gut nicht. Hör zu, was ich jetzt sage, Mann. Mache das. Du machst das so gut. Aber die Linke muss oben bleiben. Er hat immer so ein Ding noch drin, ja? Verstehst du mich?
Yeah, it just seemed as if he was starting to tire, feel the pace a little bit in that round, Pulev. And that allowed Chisora to really work hard and pull out a round and show he's still got something left.
Bouncing on his feet up early, Pulev, who was holding a bit in that last round. But it's an engaging fight, isn't it? It's a good one.
Yeah, it's a good one, yeah. Plenty of actions, good skills as well.
No massive drama. Chisora landed a good shot in the sixth round and had a good night. Glad you gave him one of the earlier ones, but apart from that, it's pretty much been Kubrat Pulev behind the jab with the uppercuts, the right hands, the space, the timing. That's just so far proved the winner here. He's got 9 minutes left, Derek Chisora, to try and salvage this European heavyweight title shot, regain that belt that he once held. Shot Derek, they're saying in the corner. They're still believing. He missed that by a country mile. Is he as good as he was when he fought Vitali Klitschko, Derek Chisora?
No, I'm not sure he quite is. I think that was his big night. He put everything he possibly could into that. And I don't think he's quite the same.
The combinations that aren't really flowing for Chisora. The old sporadic shot, but there's the right again from Pulev. Back behind that jab. That's where Chisora can ill afford to be at this stage.
He needn't be there. He needs to get out, work away, push him on the back foot. He's got to try and take it away from Pulev. You know, he looked like he was starting to tire in the last round a bit. It needs a big, big effort from Del Boy.
Body shots again. Trying to rattle them home. Bit redder now, Pulev. But he's strong and tough and conditioned. And they normally are, I think, Vector.
Yeah. Yeah, he's done his work in the gym. Pulev holding on a little bit. Just the referee, I'd like to see him shout break and let Pulev step off. He's not doing that.
David Price, who is making his ring return at the Everton show, Goodison Park, the Tony Bellew card on Sunday, May the 29th. He sparred with both of them. He fancied Pulev to win this on points. Probably going to be right, unless Chisora can somehow step it up again. Had a good night, needed a very good 10th. Hasn't had it.
No. Landing with a few body punches, trying to push forward there, but it looks as if Chisora is feeling the effects of that big round in the last. It's been quite a physical fight as well. There's been lots of pulling and work inside like that, which takes an awful lot out of you.
There's been plenty of commitment from both of them.
Well, very much so. You can see how much this fight means to both of them. Important fight.
Pulev offers the glove. Chisora doesn't want to know. He wants to sit down.
Well, there's been a bit too much of this with Chisora content to stay on it, on the ropes in the corner, and that's give Pulev some good opportunities in the round to really be in control. Not enough in that round for Derek Chisora. Not long left.
Glimpses, flashes from Chisora. Plenty of heart, grit. He's stubborn as always. But the quality has been with this man, Kubrat Pulev. Into the 11th round. And he's had success here before. Pulev with a couple of stoppage wins over Dimitrenko and Ustinov. A good level that, since to get you late on, you've got him six up.
Yep. Not long left for Chisora to try and salvage this. Can't for me on points.
It's double the punches thrown, and quality-wise, double landed. Tells the story. Bit of holding, yes, from Pulev. Little bit of a sign, possibly, around the ninth of Chisora. Trying to turn this around, and he's still in there. He's still trying to throw the leather. But it's more wayward. I mean, they're both tired now.
Yeah, but it's been some good work from Pulev, and you know he's going to be tough. He's going to be a tough opponent for anybody out there, isn't he?
I was just about to ask you, you know, how do you think he fares with the likes of a young Joseph Parker or a Carlos Takam, or of course of Anthony Joshua or Tyson Fury?
Well, I think a really good opponent for the likes of Anthony Joshua, because he's solid. You know, he's had good amateur success for a long, long time. You know, and he's you know, there's only Vladimir Klitschko has really upset him and got him out of there. So this you know, this is somebody where you'd get rounds out of Joshua.
Yep, maybe a good opponent for Joshua later in the year. Kubrat Pulev, he's ranked 3 by the WBC, 15 by the WBA, 6 by the IBF. Winning this eliminator puts him right in the mix. Jabs and right hands and the uppercut. And left from Chisora here, and a body shot as well. A swing and a miss, and that right eye is puffing up too for Derek Chisora.
Yeah, he's under fire here. Chisora keeps trying to fight back off the ropes with that big overhand right, but the defense of Pulev is kept pretty tight the second part of the fight.
Jumps in with the left hook, but looks down at his corner. Chisora, as if to say, just hasn't been my night. Nothing's really worked, and the jab there was almost non-existent, and he's back in the corner. And Pulev could just tee off on him again. This is exactly what he does. If he's trying to play possum, isn't all this too late?
Yep, solid round again for Pulev. It looks like he's resigned himself to a loss here, Chisora.
Yeah, he just falls on the top rope there, Derek Chisora. Almost a forlorn figure.